All right, Virgo time. You ready? For all of us Virgos out here, let's do this. What's up? Oh. Pulled the moon. The moon is the card that represents the psyche. And we were talking about this earlier this morning. So the journey for humankind has been, you know, out of the deep abyss, the formless void. And our first step on the evolutionary journey was to come into a mindset that was very like fight or flight, survival of the fittest. You know, what do I have to do to continue to pass on my genes? What do I have to do to survive? What do I have to do to be here? And those functions are still alive and well in our brains, and we need to be aware of that. And again, we, like I was talking about this morning, the moon's been heavy on my mind the past few days. But like we have to negotiate between the wildness of ourselves as creatures, as human creatures, and, you know, the domesticated version of humanity, as is what works in a society, as is what is applicable to community, as is what is applicable to our neighbors and the people around us, and being aware of how our actions influence them. So I think this for Virgo is basically like, we need to recognize that all of these motivations that make us move, you know, maybe we're not as aware of ourselves as we think ourselves to be. Virgo is really being asked to be humble in this moment and recognize that even when you feel a sense of illumination, 95% of you is a mystery to yourself. The subconscious is about 95% of our processes. And even the light of the moon, you know, while it is a great light, it's called the lesser light for a reason, because the kind of light that it casts is that of borrowed illumination, and borrowed illumination is always shadowy. And we need to understand, like, you know, humans don't have the ability to know. We borrow illumination from those who have gone and lived and experienced before us. And it's important to keep that as a humbling factor as we move through the stages of our evolution. We need to remember what it is to be a human, what constitutes the human psyche. It's complex. It's, you know, layered. And everything that we think we see as being accurate and true and the point is most likely just a half-truth. So let's ask ourselves, you know, where can I imagine? Not even how can I conceptualize stuff that I don't see, I'm not aware of, but how can I imagine that if 5% of me is conscious and 95% is unconscious, and I think I know so much, can I just imagine how much I don't know? And can I keep that in mind as I'm like pursuing myself? Because that humility is super important for analytical minds like Virgo energy. We have the ability, and we have the unique, distinct goal in our lives to transcend judgment and really purify it to pure discernment. So we need to be really, Virgos especially, analytically, we need to be super aware that just because our way we feel like is the most efficient way doesn't mean that it is, doesn't mean it's the only way. And we need to constantly recognize that, you know, we all are contending with these very unique, intricate layers of becoming that, depending on what avenue or path you took, is going to be different to the individual. So.